the headquarters.
In the early days of late 2011, when Pinewood had bought a rickety, dank, old 12-story building from a company called Phoenix Enterprises for $39 million, Pinewood invested $665,961,000,000 in renovations. By the time construction was completed in 2012, the tower was worth a whopping $666 billion. And nowadays it's only worth 391 Happy and Ham sandwiches. But that's beside the point. After the tragedy of 9/11, or should I say accident, the insurance company only offered to pay for walls made out of coke. And after careful review of the building, we thought this would be a very, very viable option. When planning out the workspace of the headquarters, Pinewood administration has bought 300 individual cubicles for our workers. But we didn't buy workers. No, those are way too expensive. Because the helicopter pad up the headquarters doesn't include railings, once in a while we get jumpers, and they sue us, whatever. But every month we pay our attorneys just a little bit extra to keep those, you know, stories of those jumpers under wraps. Pinewood Builders has air conditioners outside to increase the quality and our overall growth. One day in the building, Mr. DEFG had spilled his coffee cup due to some investment strategy. On that seat, the board stopped to spend $62,000 on safety harnesses for a rubber walking staff. Instead, the word safety harness worked into giant death laser, and we invested $62,000 on it. They have no more window washers, and it's only due to the board. For years, the constant waffle dispenser has crowed at the metal grate in front of the vending machine on the fifth floor. There is said to be a legend of heroic Pinewood character. What did the vending machine and the metal return? Some speculate to Belgium. Many say there's an incinerator at the bottom, where food goes in, comes out. To this day, Robloxians report hearing the tender cries of the lost Pinewood character. Where he is now, nobody knows.
Only security people know. The end.